Hey everyone, welcome back to Six Sister Stuff. Today we're gonna make a delicious chicken Tuscan pasta. So my name is Kristen.
I'm Camille.
And usually you just see me on the YouTube channel, but I am so excited that my sisters are joining us on YouTube.
I'm happy to be here too. Thanks for having me.
Anytime. So if you guys didn't know, we have a website called Six Sister Stuff, and on there we have what, like 3,000 recipes?
Yeah, over 3,000 recipes.
And so we love showing people how to make simple, easy recipes that they can make that don't take a lot of time.
Totally.
And then they can just like sit down with their family at dinner.
We're all busy moms, we all have kids. Like, if it can't be done in 20 minutes, it's probably not gonna happen. So that's how we do dinner.
Exactly. So today we're making an easy chicken Tuscan pasta that can be a freezer meal, or you can just make it right there and serve it.
Yeah,
it's done in about, what, 20 minutes or so?
20 minutes start to finish. This is a good one too. Like, you could eat half and freeze half for another night.
That's a great idea.
It's also a great meal to take to somebody that maybe just had a baby or is sick or could just use a little pick-me-up. So this is one of our go-tos.
And not to mention, my kids love it.
Right?
Yeah. So, okay.
Who doesn't love chicken and pasta?
Right?
Let's be honest.
Good stuff. Yeah. Okay, let's get started.
Okay, so we're gonna start with a quarter cup of butter. Throw that into your skillet. I've got my skillet on like what, medium?
Medium.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Just kind of get that melting.
So while that's cooking, I'm gonna get about 4 cloves of garlic here. Yep. Now tell me the ratio again, because I always mess that up.
So when I love using jarred garlic, just because it's one less thing that you have to do. It's maybe not as fresh tasting as regular garlic, but it's so simple. So a quarter teaspoon, no, half teaspoon.
Half teaspoon, I was like, oh no.
Equals a clove of garlic.
Okay, so we're gonna do
4 of those.
4 half teaspoons,
yep.
Got it.
Lots of garlic, lots of flavor.
Lots of flavor.
And when you add it to this butter that's browning, it really brings out not only the flavor of the butter, but the flavor of the garlic.
Oh, and I love the smell of it.
Oh my gosh, right?
Mm-hmm.
You just do this, and then your husband comes home from work, and
he's
thinks you're a domestic goddess. So that's how we roll.
Okay, so we're gonna cook this for just like, what, 1 to 2 minutes or so, just until the garlic becomes fragrant.
Yep.
So next we're gonna add about a half tablespoon of basil leaves. Now you can use fresh if you want
to. If you've got that.
I'm all about simple and easy and sometimes.
And things that you have on hand.
Right, so it's just a half tablespoon there. Okay, next we're gonna add about 8 ounces of cream cheese. Now, secrets, tips, what do you do when?
So obviously it's gonna melt faster and turn creamier if you cut it up into cubes.
Okay.
So kind of cut it into some little things. I love using, there's one that I have at my grocery store. It's a Greek yogurt cream cheese.
Oh, I never heard
of
that.
So it has extra protein, not as much fat and calories.
Okay.
Tastes the same. So you could sub it in. You could use a lighter cream cheese, but.
So it's not pretty, but it's gonna get the job done, so.
Yep.
There we go.
Just some cubes, toss it in there.
Nice.
And then you're gonna kind of just stir it around, let it melt. I'm gonna turn my heat up just a little bit above medium.
Now, when this starts to melt, it kind of goes like chunky in a way.
Yeah, curly.
Yes. So just keep stirring and it'll be okay.
So it will all smooth out. So if you are struggling with ideas of what to make for dinner, something you can find on our site, something that we've been working on for years, is putting together menu plans.
And I think it started because we were so frustrated.
Yeah.
I mean, me personally, I hate putting together menu plans.
Yes.
Probably my least
favorite
thing.
Figuring out what to make for dinner.
Right.
It's like the kids want dinner every night.
And then you have to make a shopping list. And then you have to go to the store and pick everything up.
No, when's the last time you went to the store? Let's be honest.
It's been
a while. We just use the pickup at the grocery store. Order on our apps, pick it up.
Exactly.
So one thing that we offer through our site are weekly menu plans. And we've got different plans for different people. For those of you who are maybe healthy, we've got healthy options. If maybe you have a smaller family or it's just you and your spouse, we've got small family options.
And one of our plans is called the standard plan. So even though it's, I mean, kind of like recipes like this.
Yes, everyday recipes.
But it still is a lot better than going out and picking up fast food.
Yeah, and you're going to save a ton of money too by not going out to eat all the time, going through the drive-thru.
Exactly.
And we have found there's so much magic in family dinner. Like, that's where you really connect with each other.
Yes.
And
that's when I can finally get like my kids to talk to me.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And I feel like that was such an important part of our childhood.
Yeah.
that family dinner is everything. So any way you can get your family to the table, we just hope that our plans, by us doing the hard work, that it works out.
Yeah. So just if you want more information about our menu plans, you can
We can link to it below.
Oh, that's a great idea. We'll put a link in the description, or you can go to sixsistersmenuplan.com.
Yeah, and we'll mail you not only like the menu for the week, so we send it to you like laid out, but then we send you all the recipes, and the best part, we send you the shopping list. Woo! So we make it super easy. Yes. All you have to do is take that shopping list to the store, pick up the items, and then you can cook these quick and easy meals.
Yep, or I just like to type it into the website and then have it delivered to me. So.
Same.
All right, now that it's all nice and creamy,
smoothed out, and it smells so good.
Right, we're gonna thicken it up a little bit with some Parmesan cheese.
Yes, cheese makes the world a better place.
I agree.
Well,
all right.
Okay.
So Parmesan is in, and it's gonna be melty, and that's gonna help it thicken up a little bit. So we have 8 ounces of that Parmesan cheese.
Yeah, look how fast it's thickening up.
Seriously. Mm. Okay, so while this is going, now if you can look, you can see that the oil is kind of spread to the sides. Mm-hmm. It's okay, it will all mix together. Just keep putting it together.
Just keep stirring.
Exactly. So we have now salt and pepper, a half teaspoon of salt, and then a half teaspoon of pepper. And you can add more if you want to, but I feel like that's a good amount.
Yeah. You can kind of eyeball it too, if you don't want to measure.
That's true. Okay, that's looking nice and creamy. Mm-hmm. Let's add our chicken and tomatoes. So, this is an 8 ounce jar of sun-dried tomatoes. We just had to chop them up because you don't want a huge bite of tomatoes.
No. So. And it does come in oil, so it's better to kind of pull them out.
Kind of drain the oil off of them.
Yeah, chop them up.
Yeah, so we'll just put those in there.
But it's just a really rough chop. Doesn't have to be pretty.
Exactly. It just gives it really good flavor.
Yeah.
And then while you're stirring that in, we're gonna add about 1.5 cups of shredded chicken. Now, those of you who love the Instant Pot, I made this chicken in my Instant Pot, and if you wanna know how to do that, I'll put a link in the description for you. 1.5 cups of chicken.
You could also use rotisserie chicken, or buy the chicken already cooked at the store too.
Okay, so I've seen that they have the rotisserie chicken that's already cut up, and you can just buy it that way.
It's the best thing ever. You don't even have to worry about the rotisserie chicken carcass. You just...
I think that's the worst part of the rotisserie.
I know. So they already do it. It's like a dollar more per pound, worth every penny.
Yep. Okay, this is looking good.
Yep.
So before we started filming, we made some pasta in the Instant Pot.
Yeah.
And so...
Quick and easy, but 4 minutes.
So we cooked this for about, 4 minutes in the Instant Pot?
4 minutes.
Super easy. We did the 16 ounces and did about 2 cups of water.
Yep.
4 minutes, and then did a quick release when it was done. So now you have a few options with this recipe.
Okay.
So you can actually add the pasta in the sauce and mix it all together.
Okay.
Or if your kids don't like sauce or they want plain noodles, you can also just put the noodles in and then the sauce on top.
Cool.
So I
think, do you want to do?
I think maybe let's put the pasta
let's
in
dump
there.
It
Is
in.
It going to be okay?
You bet.
All right. We're going to use this little guy to kind of get it loose. One thing about the Instant Pot pasta is I don't have to drain the water or anything.
That is so crazy.
2 cups, and it just fills up your pasta.
And it's perfectly cooked.
There you go.
I love the Instant Pot.
Me too.
Yeah, I like adding it all in. That's perfect.
Me too. It just makes it, everything
just
is coated.
So quick and easy.
Good. Yeah.
Yep.
Okay, so when you are making this recipe, you have the option of, eating it right then, but it makes quite a bit. So I like to freeze the other half. And on busy nights, we eat the other half. So you can put it in the freezer, or you can just put it in a container and have it for leftovers.
Call it good. So once it's done, this is heavy. That is a lot of pasta.
I'm just gonna help you dump it in.
Perfect.
Is that okay?
Yep.
So now these are kind of big pans. You can get those square small ones.
Yeah, I would say this is like a 9x13. You could get 2 8x8s or 9x9s.
Yeah.
And that would be perfect too. Yeah, that fills up the whole pan.
The whole pan.
Yep. Yeah. So with freezer meals, I love freezer meals. I make them all
the
time.
You are like the queen of freezer meals.
Mm-hmm. That's how I get through this life. You're just gonna wanna make sure that you get this wrapped with aluminum foil really well. Okay. In fact, sometimes I'll do foil one way, and then I'll go in and do it the other way as well.
Oh, okay.
Just to make sure it's like fully sealed. And you might need one more.
So, like, for the top. How long will this last in your freezer?
So, I like to eat my freezer meals within 60 days.
Okay.
I think past 60 days, it starts to get a little bit kind of that freezer taste, freezer burn. But 30 to 60 days is like the sweet spot. And so you wanna make sure, like, grab a Sharpie marker and write what it is and the date so that you can remember when it's in your freezer. Another way you could do this would be to put it in a Ziploc bag, like a big gallon-sized Ziploc
bag.
You bet. Awesome. Pour that pasta in there, and then it will lay flat in your freezer, and you can stack stuff on top of it.
I love
Stacking
that.
Stuff on this is gonna be a little bit hard until it's frozen.
Gotcha.
So maybe put it in the freezer first.
Okay.
Let it freeze, and then you can stack stuff on it.
Perfect.
But to pull it out, here's the tricky part. Okay. You need to pull it out 24 hours in advance.
Okay.
So if I knew I was gonna eat this on Friday night, I'd pull it out Thursday night.
That makes sense.
Put it in your fridge.
Okay.
Let it sit in your fridge for those 24 hours. Nice. It might still be a little bit frozen in the middle. If you do it in an aluminum foil pan like this, I would just pop it in the oven for like a half hour.
Oh, okay.
And then it will be like a casserole.
Nice. And in the plastic bag, you just like reheat it in a container.
Yep, a container. You could throw it in a slow cooker. You could throw it back in a skillet and just heat it up. You might have to add a little bit of milk just to kind of get it
going
moist again.
Gotcha.
But it will work. So this is a great thing. Imagine if you took this to your neighbor. Like,
they would love you
this
forever.
This would be the best gift ever. If someone brought me dinner, BFFs for life.
Nice. Now, if you want more freezer meal ideas, we have a blog post that's 50 freezer meal ideas.
Yeah.
So we'll put a link in the description.
I love freezer meals. So we're always looking for new ideas of freezer meals. So if you have a favorite, we'd love for you to leave a comment below to your favorite freezer meal. And who knows, maybe we'll put it on our next video.
Exactly. All right, guys, thanks so much for stopping by. We will see you next week.